Everybody, welcome back to Univesco TV. I'm here joined by my very good friend, Gujin Lee. Gujin Lee is a senior consultant at our firm, and he's also a very good friend. So, Gujin Lee, if you can explain to our audience the benefits of, advantage of an offshore company for Chinese companies and also foreign-owned Chinese companies, so office in Chinese, so if we have some audience who speak Chinese, they can also understand and get a better understanding.
OK， 现在中国的外贸公司嘛，一般因为进出口还是用自己的公司。那现在如果你有一家离岸公司的话，可以说离岸公司的税率在这个政策上是非常有优势的，因为现在在中国嘛，你这个 VAT 的贸易要达到13%，然后你退税的话要经历3个月到4个月。那企业所得税在年收入100万以下的话是5%。然后100万到300万的话是15%，那这个所得企业所得税是非常高的。但如果你用了一个外国的这个离岸公司去收款付款，那你这个企业所得税可以免除，包括这个 VAT 都是可以免除的。所以说，离岸公司它对外贸公司的资金周转税率方面都有很大的好处，包括在资金的限额上也有好处，因为你货币周转，你中国公司不一定每年每月每天有多少的有限制，那美金限制，那离岸公司它是没有这样一个限制的。所以这两大好处现在就是现在很多贸易公司都会有在香港甚至在国外有注册一家离岸公司去收取这个货款。
Thank you so much. So I just want to add some points. I don't know if Rish mentioned in Chinese, but also many people have this myth, they have this understanding that offshore companies are only for drug lords, they're only for criminals, only for politicians, blah, blah, blah. Sorry. Honestly, it's just a way of saving their income, just trying to reduce tax. Tax evasion is not allowed, but tax avoidance is. So you can avoid your tax, and many of the big Fortune 500 companies also usedeferred tax. So Google's, Amazon and all them, they don't necessarily pay tax now, but they just defer the tax and then pay them later if they pay them. It's just a way of reducing your tax liabilities and increasing your profit margin. So an offshore company works for any sort of business, and it's just a way of structuring your deals where you pay the least amount of tax possible. You're still paying tax, but it's not as paying as much as you would in your home country, and that's just a way. And it's a legal structure, so there's nothing illegal about it. You're just not paying as much tax as you would. There are jurisdictions in the world where taxes are lower. Ireland, for example, it's only 12.5%, whereas compared to China, it's 5, 10 and 25%. So it depends, you know, it depends on the jurisdiction. Some countries have 30%, some countries have 40%, some countries have 25%, 15%. So every country has their own different rates of tax bans. And just by having an offshore company, you're basically creating a shelter for yourself where you're paying the least amount of taxes, and that just increases your profit. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions on offshore, please do write to us or comment in the description below, and we'd be more than happy to assist you with any queries you have. Thanks so much for watching.